One of the reader has asked this question, and the question is on the screen. What Ramesh is asking over here is that does QCI 1 and QCI 5, do they get attached to the network simultaneously, or do they get attached separately? So I am assuming from the question that the gentleman is familiar with the attach procedure and the setting up of the EPS bearer. So in order to answer the question, QCI 5 and QCI 1 attach do not happen together. In simple, QCI 1 will only be set up whenever there is a voice call needs to be established. What do I mean by this? So I have drawn this diagram. I am not going to explain how the EPS bearer attach works, but just to answer the question being asked by Ramesh is that QCI 1 and QCI 5 will not be established simultaneously unless there is a voice call need to be going on. When you power on your phone and the assuming the network is VoLTE enabled and the user or the UE equipment is also VoLTE enabled, what will happen is default EPS bearer will be established first. Usually the default EPS bearer is QCI 9, and after that the other IMS signaling EPS bearer will be established, which is QCI 5. Once this is established, this only is responsible for carrying IMS signal. If a user wants to dial a phone call or dial a number or anything like this, then this QCI 5 bearer will be used to carry IMS signaling via PGW towards the IMS. And then as a result of the signaling, this QCI 1 bearer will be established. So once QCI 5 will carry IMS signaling, then QCI 1 bearer will be established, and this QCI 1 bearer will be used to carry voice traffic. So this will be actually used for your voice traffic or any kind of traffic which is being carried by the sent by the IMS network. In this case, we are talking about voice. So let's just write it over here, voice data. Now, having said that, let's say you are on a voice call for the next 5 minutes. So for the next 5 minutes, this QCI 1 bearer will remain established. After 5 minutes, you hang up the call. QCI 1 bearer then will be taken down. So meaning it will be then removed. So let me remove it over here once the voice call is done. And then again, after its removal, what will remain? QCI 5 and default EPS bearer for IP connectivity and internet connectivity will remain there. So to answer the question from this explanation, QCI 1 and QCI 5, if you're continuously on a voice call, will remain established as long as you are requesting voice traffic, voice data at the same time. Once you are not requesting any kind of voice services, voice data, then QCI 1 will be taken down, but QCI 5 will remain there because that acts as a default IMS signaling bearer. It will be carrying any kind of IMS signaling in order to set up QCI 1 bearer, in order to take down QCI 1 bearer, so on and so forth. So that's the answer to that question. Thank you. And thank you for the question, Ramesh.